Hi friends, and welcome to the next video. In this video, we're gonna talk about China. What it's like to be a drummer in China. What you need to know about China to play over there. And my thoughts in general about the music scene that I saw over there. Okay, now I'd like to start off first by saying that there's so many misconceptions about China. It's kind of typical. No matter what country you go to, everybody has some kind of opinion about what that it's going to be like. You know, when I went to India, I lived in India for 2 years, and everybody said, "Oh, you're going to get malaria, you're going to get a brain infection, you're going to get bitten by snakes, and you're going to die." And of course, none of that happened. You know, the same thing with China. Before I started going over there a lot, I actually lost friends. I lost friends because they were opposed to me going to China and playing. Mostly, you know, guys from the USA. They were so opposed to me going over there. And I mean, I'm talking about friends of many years that I've known very well. And we don't speak anymore because I decided to go play in China. And it's so unbelievable the amount of misconceptions that people have about different places. So, you know, one of the first things I would suggest to anyone wanting to be a musician is don't say anything about a place unless you've been there. This is a very, very important point, okay? Because you're not going to know the truth until you're there, until you see what's going on for yourself. So, with that said, I think China is an absolutely brilliant, incredibly advanced country. They have a huge passion for drumming. You can see it in the many schools that they have. They have thousands and thousands of music schools, okay, all over the country. And I've been lucky enough to tour, you know, I've been there 4 times already. And I've toured at a lot of these schools. I've done photography expeditions. I'm a photographer also, I'm sure you guys know by now. But it's an incredible country, so beautiful. And the people are beautiful. They're so nice, very nice. They love music and they love drumming, which is something that I have in common with them. You know, I'm sure a lot of people love drumming across the world. But the thing about China is that it's a very new thing. It's a pretty new thing, the drum set and this passion for drumming that's exploding over there, you know. So what do I think of all that? I think it's a fantastic thing. You know, there's so many schools that they can't find enough teachers to go around. You know, there's obviously it's teachers for children, you know, children playing, a lot of children getting introduced to music, and that's a great thing. But I don't see a lot of like pro players on the scene. You know, I didn't get to see a whole lot of pro players. I just don't think there are many at all. You know, there aren't many drummers like on the scene working, gigging musicians like we know in the West. You know, I know there's huge rock bands and stuff like that, but I don't think the scene is like rich enough for anyone to go over there and think, okay, I'm going to be part of the scene and blah, blah, blah. Not going to happen. Plus, there's a huge language barrier. You're not going to get far if you don't know to speak Chinese. You know, I had translators on every single trip. Professional translators and guides and stuff like that. So you can actually see all about my trips to China on the channel here on my video blogs about my tours. And yeah, the scene, the music itself, there's not a lot of like super hip music. You know, the music in Asia has a particular tinge to it. Now I've seen the same kind of thing in Thailand and Indonesia. And there's not a whole lot of funk going on, you know, not a whole lot of let's say, music outside of the taste of Chinese or Asian people in general. When I say Asia, I'm speaking of China in general. So Asia is gigantic. It's, you know, all the Asian countries, including India and stuff like that. So we're talking about a gigantic swath of the planet. But I'm trying to keep things into the China perspective, okay? So in Indonesia and Thailand and places like that, I didn't get to see much super great music, you know. So I would think that they're still developing into this whole thing, and they have a great passion for what they do. Now, I have seen, the reason I'm saying this is I've seen some players from the West go over there and try to be, you know, like the man in China. They go over there, they're just anybody that they're fooling is, you know, I feel very sorry for, because they're basically, these guys are fooling people. They're completely mediocre players, and they go to China and take advantage of the innocence of the Chinese people and the emerging scene, you know. But anywhere there's heavy drumming going on, they would be completely mediocre. So this is really something that bothers me, that they're deceiving, they're taking advantage of the innocence, you know, of the people there who love music. And it is an innocence, you know. They don't know, they're not used to getting swindled by the music scene, I don't think, you know. They're not like, we have so many jive turkeys in the West, you know, that prop themselves up and this, that. Unbelievable, you know. Of course, any experienced player is going to be able to tell that this guy's completely jive. But they don't have that a whole lot over there. So, that said, now, if you want to go to China and play, my best advice is do the best that you can, okay? Be honest. Be an upright person. Be someone who promotes the art of drumming. And be humble, all right? Know what you can do, know what you can't do, and don't trick people. Don't try to trick people, because eventually it's going to come out, you know? as the more experience they get, the more contact with different players from different parts of the world they get, they're going to know that, you know, eventually, that someone is jive. It's kind of happening now, but not fast enough for my taste. There's guys over there going like for $100 to play somewhere, you know, all the way from wherever, you know, the United States to China, just so they can say, I played in China, I toured in China, when in reality what they did is just lie, right? Just completely doing things that are immoral in my eyes, you know, showing bad information, just really just taking advantage of the situation. So if you're going to go there, you know, make sure that you're being honest with yourself and where you're at, and try to be a good person, a good ambassador for drumming. That's all I can say, you know. Of course, there's many great players that go over there too. Many great players. Not lately, because there's the whole pandemic thing. You know, I haven't been to China in 2 years now, but I talk to my buddies in China all the time, almost every other day. You know, and we're trying to plan the next tour and stuff like that. But I think the situation in China is absolutely beautiful, because what's happening is they're creating a generation of drummers, okay, that if they do it right, can be the best drummers in the world, because it's a thing where they have such a nice passion for music that it can be great. They need the right information. You know, all my friends in China, if you're watching this, you need the right information, you need the right people around you. It's like anywhere else, you know, you have to eventually think about dominating your body, dominating the craft, you know, and overcoming all the hurdles that you need to overcome on a personal level to be a musician. Now, a musician is something not very easy to be accepted as in Asian society in general, even in India, you know, my students had a lot of pressure once they turned 19, 20. Okay, you got to stop that stuff now and become an engineer or a doctor or whatever. And it was a tremendous pressure. And anyone that's still a drummer over there, you know, that got through that is, it's a miracle to me, you know. But by the way, in India, you can't be at Jive Turkey and go over there and think you're going to do something, because that's a drumming mecca of the world. You know, that's a drumming mecca, so that you'll be spotted like immediately. I like to say, like going, like a cat going to a dog party wearing a dog costume. You know, they're going to sniff you out in 2 seconds, right? Okay, so anyway, that said, I'd like you to have a look at my lesson site, okay? Very important. My lesson site is one of the most complete in the world. It's used, all my material is used at top universities, some of the best drum schools in the world. And for only $100, you can check out the entire year program, okay? So if that's something interesting for you, check that out. Speaking of having the right information, there's lots of websites out there that's just complete garbage. Let's say it honestly, you know, peddling, you know, just completely wrong information, and really, it's a shame. It's a shame that people feel the need to do that. Anyway, my friends in China say that the situation has changed drastically now since the pandemic, and we're waiting to see what's going to happen. We're all waiting to see what's going to happen. If the music scene is going to take off again, or what, you know, they're still in lockdown over there. They're still doing a heavy lockdown situation, and it's we've been trying to get this, my next tour started forever since the pandemic started, you know. And it keeps getting pushed back and back and back until we're almost like, okay man, what are we going to do, you know? But there is hope that China is going to open next year, maybe during the middle of the year or something like that, and there's hope that we're going to get out there again. So those are my views about China. The culture is, in my opinion, so advanced. They've got incredible bullet trains, incredible food. The food is so good in China. Such a huge variety. You know, don't listen to people, what they say about the food in China. It's absolutely incredible, delicious, incredible, huge variety. And, you know, like I said in the beginning, there's so many misconceptions that you really have to be careful who you listen to. My take on that is, listen to people that have actually been there, that have seen what's up, that know people there, and that can give an opinion from being on the ground, okay, and experiencing it many times. You know, not just one time, a couple of days. You know, it's something that's very important as a musician that you understand, because when you're on the road, you're a representative of a culture, and whether you like it or not, you know, you want to be a representative of music most of all, not of any one particular culture. So if you are an upright person, you know, upstanding morally with the dissemination of information, then that gives a good feeling, first of all, but also gives you a good position of being an ambassador of music, and that's going to karmically pay off, because you'll be called to go back and go to the next country and the next, and that, I mean, that's how I did it, okay? So anyway, I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you got something out of it. And please check out my lesson site. It's like I said, you have me there on your side. I'm there all the time. You're interacting with me directly. Only $100 gets you in the year program. All right, my friends. Peace out. See you in the next video.